by phone, so, you know, maybe you can keep glasses to try and get to see, but it really helps the overall presentation. Okay? So that's one thing that I would love to see, pull themselves up and point and direct that sound into the audience, and I think that'll make a substantial difference anyways. Now, one thing, maybe we can go back to the first chart. These have the common terms, right? You know, can somebody bring up the comment sheet that I wrote? Because, you know, overall, I like a lot of things you're doing. I think in the first chart, what I would like to hear is more dynamic contrast. And, you know, what I was talking about, and I'll probably say it later, I talked about, like, the concept of trajectories, or the concept of telling a story. What I said about this is a nice one, a lengthy one, but I would like to hear more dynamic interest. And also, I'd like to hear more drive and interaction. Because before I forget, what I'd like you to do on the drums is raise up your right hand. In other words, it's when I hear what the right hand is, it's a little bit like, right? You know, it's the same pattern all the time. What I would like you to do, records of drums and players playing bass or different guys. They're more like try this, and you know there was an ensemble part where everyone comes in. It was probably at the end of the chart, like the shout chorus, 105. So let's try it, a bar before 105. And the thing is, what I was going to say is, you know, I always talk about this, but you know, here we are, we're playing blowing into metal, we're playing beats. We're supposed to give the music character. In other words, there's an emotional quality of trying to perform an audience. Okay, now one of the things that I always talk about is that you have to think like a team. So for example, quarterbacks of the team, like the lead trumpet player and the drummer. The drummer sets the swing field, and the lead trumpet player sets the style. The captains of the team are the lead trumpet player. So what you have to try to do is make your lead player sound great. Really follow the style of the drummer. You're all playing in an ensemble setting, cut off together. You know, one thing that makes bands really play, if you think about this, has something to do with really anything, you know, like practice down for more hours. If you breathe together, cut off together, phrase together, it really makes it, you know, it brings it to another level. So let's try the shout chorus at 105. Try that. department, 113 and 114. And I want to hear it from, not blasting, but basically, a nice, full sound with soft as you can play with intensity. So it's like,
Come on.
long-term experience drives the bottom of this community. Everyone has to become part of it. So I would just say, trying to, and some of the other comments I was giving, and I said this exactly, about that, the Alco Sax, I said, very pretty Alco Sax sound, the horn section needs to tune from the bottom up to support the intensity of your airstream to fill in the voice needs that you need. Okay? In other words, here you have this great Alco solo. What you need to do is make her sound like the greatest Alco solo that's ever lived. That's your job. That's the moment. It's to support her and make her sound great. So what you need to do is the intensity of your airstream and listen to the core. And for example, you know how your experience is now to know that you have that. If you have a funny note, like, you know, a color tone, well, don't just blare it and blast it out, especially if she's playing solo. You can see, find your spot in the voice. And I just thought that, you know, you guys have a lot of really great interviews.